quite the storms that blew through tonight from around 8 to 9 and still going in some places. This is Terrebonne Parish where we've got the strongest storms, but even one isolated storm remaining in some of the river parishes. So WDSU First Warning Weather Doppler radar is where we start. Heat busters, that's what I've been calling them, Facebook Live when they came through. So this is kind of the lone cell, the positive lightning strike coming out of this. And as it moves southwest, it's going to be just clipping some areas, the Lutcher, maybe Convent, and just outside as we go from St. James Parish. We look farther south and still have steady rain ongoing, so the rain's not done even here. And technically, we've got a flood advisory for the next 12 minutes, but most of the rain has really subsided. There's the heaviest storms. Then as we go to more marshy areas in the Terrebonne Parish, and so really out of more populated areas, some camps could be affected, but that's about it. Some last lightning strikes to Donner, and we got quite a bit of rain, came down in torrents. It was about 1 to 2 inches very quickly. About 1 inch in some parts of the city around Jefferson, even around Madisonville, I saw about 1 inch of rain recorded today. Real-time temperatures were in the 70s to around 80, 75 Galliano. That's one of the coolest temperatures we've had in some time. But we got to focus on the tropics because the National Hurricane Center yesterday came up and said, listen, we're going to watch the Gulf as we've been doing all the way to last week. You look at the first wave of storm activity and in a broader view, still connected from the first wave, high humidity, and all the way down to the storms that extend to the country of Cuba. This is all connected to a system, as I'll show. Tropical conditions with water temperatures warm enough, high tropical humidity in the air, low wind shear surrounding the storms as they move through, is that heat dome right on top of us is high pressure, a lack of anything that could tear storms apart. So favorable conditions, there's the humidity plume, there's a system there that provides some energy and some spin a few miles into the air, but the area of a broad low pressure here at sea level and at ground where we are has been identified from the National Hurricane Center just off the Big Bend. So usually those two need to be correlated to really get something to develop. Our high-risk forecast doesn't show a whole lot organization or even really strengthening from Thursday to Friday, and then we're moving into the Texas coast and we don't have any chance of development from there. I want to get to the high-risk forecast now to show that we don't have much strengthening organization, so I don't find even a tropical depression's in our cards. But look at the scattered storms on Thursday. We got a good bet at this, 80, 90% shot that we get storms. So even you're going to need the rain gear headed to work, being around town. French Quarter, those in town too. Friday, more scattered storms off and on. It's not raining the entire time, but as you know, when that comes in bouts, could come down in torrents, even all the way into Saturday. Upgraded our rain chances here too. So scattered storms each day for Thursday to Friday into Saturday as we wind things down. But that's going to hold temperatures down. The chance that we could get something tropical, that's that area identified National Hurricane Center, extremely low, and we only have the next 2 days to do something. So the low chance of the formation, but the tropical humidity means storms, and that's what broke the heat, and that's what's going to keep temps down. So temperature-wise with the scattered storms, 70s to around 80 to wake up tomorrow, and we're topping out around 90, give or take a degree or two. Locally heavy rain possible, so there is a low risk if you've got tickets, Saints training camp for Thursday. You might want to have some rain gear. That's going to be a big thing. Temperature-wise, not as bad as it's been. The same will go for Friday with highs around 90 and low risk for possible locally heavy rain and flooding. The Tarpon Rodeo, still watching for possible hefty rain there too. You're going to have to dodge some storms. At least it's not blistering heat. WDSU First Warning Weather 7 days. So we're around 90 the next couple of days. See, not too bad, but then the storms will be there and we'll have to contend with them all the way through Saturday. But by Sunday, Monday, the heat's right back. Could have more alerts.